talking again about the AM radio that I want to make. And here is the coil, and especially the antenna coil, so not the VFO coil. So the oscillator coil that has to work between, say, 1 megahertz and approximately 2 megahertz or 2.5 megahertz to get, say, a mixing product. Anyway, here is, say, the antenna coil for, say, medium waves, and this could be, I'm not sure, I have to test it, a good option. And to test such a coil where, say, the resonance is, you can connect it to a test oscillator. That's on my YouTube channel, the schematic is showed, etc., etc. And you can see here inside that there is a piece of ferrite. So I'll take it out so that we only have the pure radio coil. My camera runs out perhaps anyway. So let's see what this all can bring. Connect it to an oscillator, and here inside we have a 50 picofarad extra capacitor. So there's this coil and 50 picofarad parallel to it, and we have a quite good waveform. That's perhaps interesting to show. I have a lot of backlight now at the moment, and the frequency that this coil gives is 689 kilohertz, kilocycles. So that's quite good. And when I say switch my oscillator to a somewhat other position here, the frequency changes somewhat. Here it is, say, 1.3 megahertz. That is in fact very, very good. It shows that, say, this coil will work on higher frequencies. And when I say go to the other position of my oscillator, we are on 2.2 megahertz. So that shows that this coil can work in that radio band between, say, the lowest frequency, say, 689 kilohertz, and we have here a 50 picofarad capacitor. And in real, of course, we have here a tuning, a parallel tuning capacitor that goes from, say, not zero, but say 10 picofarad up to 500 picofarad. That means that we can, say, bring the frequency of this coil down, and etc. So I think quite good idea. I want to demonstrate now what the effect is when I, say, move in that ferrite rod. Direct effect, you can see it here. I move it in and out, so, and also you can see directly the effect on the, say, frequency. I have to, say, adapt the scope somewhat. So here it is, say, 577 kilocycles. And when I take that rod out, you can directly see the effect. So that's also a good way to, say, tune an AM coil to a certain frequency band. moving that rod in and out. You can glue it here. It doesn't matter much whether it is in the middle or not, and that has of course everything to do with this type of coil. Could be that in another type of coil that doesn't have that good effect, but anyway, so here you see the frequency change somewhat when I do this. So anyway, thanks for watching. Hope it was not too sloppy, the handle of my camera got loose. So anyway, good waveform, by the way, and a good waveform always tells that the quality factor of the coil is good. So when you have, say, not a pure sine wave with this test oscillator, schematic is on my YouTube channel. When you don't have a good sine wave, say distorted or kind of other waveforms, there is a kind of problem. But this, say, antenna coil shows to be good on this meter.